Hey, how's it going, guys? Mr. Boss for the win here, and in today's Red Dead Redemption 2 video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to get the best horse in the game. That's right, according to the official strategy guide from Rockstar, this is the best and most powerful horse in Red Dead Redemption 2. So there's only a couple downsides to this. Number one, you actually have to be in Epilogue 1. So I'm sure by now a lot of you guys are either there or getting there. So this shouldn't be an issue for a ton of you guys. And even if you're not there, this is something you can bookmark and always come back to a little bit later once you are there. Now, once you are in Epilogue 1, what you want to do is head to Blackwater. And once you're in Blackwater, you want to head to the stables. The only other unfortunate part about this is not a wild horse. You're going to have to spend a little bit of cash if you want the best horse in the game. So once you've headed to the stables, you're going to see the best horse in the game is now available to you, and that is the Arabian. Now, this is a special kind of Arabian. As you guys know, you can actually find a white Arabian in the wild. This is the Rose Gray Bay, and it has a price of $1,250. So I know what you guys are saying right now. $1,250 is a ton of money to spend on a horse, Mr. Boss for the win. Is this worth it? And the answer is yes. And it also sort of depends on what you're looking for in a horse. But overall, this has like the best stats in the game. Now, there's four statistics for each horse. There's health, stamina, speed, and acceleration. The lowest stat that a horse can have in those categories is 2, with the highest being 7. No stat goes above 7. So according to the in-game strategy guide, the Rose Gray Bay Arabian has health of 7, stamina of 7, speed of 6, and acceleration of 6. And of course, its category is superior, with its handling elite. Now, let's compare that to probably a horse that you guys have right now, the White Arabian, which actually has a value of $1,200, so it is just slightly less expensive in terms of value, but its stats are way different. It has health of 5, stamina of 5, and then speed of 6 and acceleration of 6. So the difference between the White Arabian and the Rose Gray Bay is it has 7 health and 7 stamina instead of 5 health and 5 stamina. So that is actually a huge difference. Now, the only other horse that compares to this is the Black Arabian horse that can actually be purchased from the Saint Denis stables in Chapter 4, which has health of 6, stamina of 6, speed of 6, and acceleration of 6. So needless to say that this horse is even better than that, because it has the highest possible stamina, highest possible health, and second highest possible speed and acceleration. So according to the in-game stats, this is the best horse in the game. It has maximum health, maximum stamina, and it is still the fastest of any horse that you can get. So you really are getting the best of both worlds here. You're getting a horse that can survive pretty much any situation, is going to be really good in terms of racing around, and is just overall one of the best horses in the game. Unfortunately, the only way in which you can get this best horse in the game is by buying it. I'd still say the best wild horse that you can get for free is by far the White Arabian, which is still going to be very comparable to this horse. It's just not going to be the tippity top of the mountain. It's not going to be the very, very best. Now, once you've acquired this horse, since once you do that, you're going to have to start your bond level over, there's actually 4 ways in which you can improve its stats to make it even better than it already is. Number one is to already bond with the horse. You're going to improve it just by doing that. Number two would be to apply any trinkets and talismans that you might have created throughout the game that will improve your horse's statistics. Number three would be able to apply an upgraded saddle. And number four would be able to apply upgraded stirrups. And if you do all 4 of those, this is going to become an unbelievable elite racing horse. So that right there is how you can get the best horse in Red Dead Redemption 2. According to its value, this is the highest value horse in the game, and also according to its stats as well. There's no other horse in the game, whether wild or bought, that has the same statistical levels as this horse right here. So as always, I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments down below. Let me know if you own this horse. Are you going to be owning this horse? Or if not, what is one you're currently using right now that you're really enjoying? Let me know your thoughts, opinions, and more in the comments down below. I'd love to hear from you guys down there. If you did go on to enjoy this video, though, a like rating would, of course, be awesome. And also subscribe to my YouTube channel if you are new or you like daily Red Dead Redemption 2 videos like this. With all the way, guys, like I said, thanks so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.